유럽인들을 충격받게 만들었던 페이커의 야스오 1대4 사건. 2014년 포나틱과의 경기 중 페이커는 야스오 선픽을 고민 중이었습니다.
I just have to mention this Yasuo because it's almost like SKT is predicting an Italy pick.
페이커가 야스오를 고르자 유럽 관중들은 환호했습니다.
Gaming ran it at Katowice. They could not deal with the crazy aggression that came out.
그리고 야스오 선픽에 웃는 또 다른 사람이 있었습니다. 야스오를 본 엑스팩케는 곧바로 K를 고릅니다.
The thing is with Fnatic, they play so much in Italy, and that's what teams pick Yasuo into normally. But this is the Kael pick. Here's the thing. Right when Yasuo released, he does not block the auto attacks from Kael. He blocks all the other ranged champions' auto attacks, but not Kael because it is not a projectile, so it will go through the wind wall. Even though Kael's been nerfed down, that is a great pick against Yasuo.
당시 야스오 선픽이 나오면 후픽으로 케일이 자주 등장했었는데 저 티어에선 야스오가 유리한 경우도 있었지만 동실력이거나 케일이 조금만 더 잘하더라도 야스오가 상당히 힘든 구조였습니다. 그 이유를 해설자들은 장막에 케일의 공격을 막을 수 없기 때문이라 했고 사람들은 이렇게 말했습니다. 미드라인 특성상 거리가 짧고 케일은 초반엔 살이는 플레이를 하다가 6렙이 되면 궁을 배우기 때문에 야스오로 동실력 케일을 솔길 내는 게 무리를 하지 않는 이상 힘들다고 말했습니다. 이 경기에서 페이커는 유럽 최고 미드라이너라 불리던 엑스팩케의 탈진 케일을 상대해야 했습니다. 거기다 상대 정글은 카직스라 야스오를 고른 페이커가 상당히 불리하다며 페이커라도 이번엔 힘들 것이라 예상했었습니다. 하지만 유럽 관중들의 생각은 달랐습니다. 페이커와 엑스팩케 중 누가 더 대단한 플레이를 할 것 같냐는 질문에 유럽 사람들은 투표했고 페이커가 51%, 엑스팩케가 49%라는 엄청난 투표 결과가 나왔습니다. 당시 유럽에서 열렸던 경기에서 유럽 최고 미드라이너를 두고 페이커를 뽑은 건 정말 대단한 것이었고 유럽에서 페이커의 인기를 실감할 수 있었던 일이었습니다. 그렇게 경기가 시작됩니다.
Came back to play that Baron. Could have turned the game, could have turned the competition on its head, but it wasn't a bit.
경기 초반부터 페이커의 견제에 엑스팩케는 진땀을 흘립니다.
For their 80 carries, they're only taking one turn, and it's more about jungler denial and mid lane isolation than it is about fast push.
Oh, Peke goes aggressive. Faker turns it round, but he had a big stack of minions hitting him in the back, which actually laid down a lot of that damage.
결국 Fnatic 탑라이너 소아즈가 미드로 로밍을 옵니다.
The jungler now he's looking. Faker goes aggressive. Solant is just off the side though. Glitterlands does not land. A fantastic wind wall from Faker to stop that Glitterlands in his tracks, and he gets away. It forces the flash, and the ignite was also burned from Faker.
페이커를 잡아내지 못한 소아즈는 라인으로 복귀하는데
Getting even gold. What's so funny about this is the whole debate between Soaz and Shy when they were talking about Shyvana and Lulu, what's better? Soaz is like better in lane. Better
Uh-oh.
This is the lane game.
Soaz caught out. He's not going to get away.
바텀 정리를 하다 암살을 당했고 소아즈는 괜히 미드 로밍을 갔다가 망해 버립니다.
Not going to get away from this one. It will be first blood. That was a quick kill from the duo lane of Piglet Mandu.
페이커는 다시 딜 교환을 시도해 봅니다.
Phase for her. She just got camped in one of those side lane rushes and taken down. You're not allowed to play against Shyvana in a game like this.
Oh, it's a good turnaround of damage from Peke. Oh, is he going to follow through? He has flash, but he's not going to go for it. He's so fearful. He has.
당시 케일이 거리 조절을 잘할 경우 이런 딜 교환이 되곤 했었습니다. 이번에는 SKT에서 엑스팩케를 노립니다.
Which he's getting ganked with rushes confidence.
You can see Bengi waiting off at the side. Cyanide is close by, as is Yellowstar. Now they know he's going to be coming. They're going to catch on towards the tower. Here comes a dart bind. It lands on Piglet. Cyanide pounces for it, but Reckless cannot get close on this one. The poison's thick.
유럽 최고 미드라이너답게 풀을 안 쓰고 생존해냅니다. 페나틱에서 피들렛 암살을 시도하려다가 오히려 페이커를 끼우게 됩니다.
Moving into position, they want to try and corner the rat.
This is the first big move the Fnatic has kind of made on their own accord. It's not a reaction to SKT. We have to see if they can get something on Piglet. He's really safe behind that minion line though. Unless he roams just out. Yellowstar wants him to, or they might just go before the minions. Can even get a binding down.
Pumandu's going to join him back on their side. Now he's going for his stealth up, goes in, gets the damage down on towards him. Piglet's actually taking the path, which is going to put him in danger. They pounce
they
on towards
him.
They can't see where he's going to go. Mandu's going to be the focus target instead. They're going to switch around towards him. The exhaust goes down. They should have enough damage. Teleport coming in. They don't know. Yellowstar's in trouble. He has to try and get out of it. Teleport was cancelled, but Cyanide's caught out. Bengi's going to come around. He's going to surely get the kill. Knocks him away. Faker manages to follow through with his ult. He takes him down. Windwall. Piglet took down Yellowstar. Reckless is in all sorts of trouble. Now you can see the windwall going out. Intervention comes out from Peke. Peke can't do anything. This is in danger of...
페이커는 이번 한타로 1킬 리어시를 먹으며 엑스페케보다 성장을 하게 됩니다. 그리고 피글렛과 엑스페케를 한 번 더 잡아내 성장을 막습니다.
In trouble. Baker comes around. Windwall actually used to stop him, slowing him down. Uses the intervention. Sinner comes around the side, but it was a quick and easy kill for Piglet. 5-0 rat.
Bad twitch right there. And
1킬 3어시를 먹은 페이커는 슈퍼 플레이를 하기 시작합니다.
Big issue and you know we talked about it at the World Finals. Oh my word. Doesn't need any help on this ulti. He goes in himself 2v1 and he may well get the kill. Soez is going to go down. Reckless doesn't want to get involved. Dark Binding does not land. And Faker gets himself for Soez.
Yeah, Faker is also in a scary place right now.
Static. 여기서 페이커의 노지컬 플레이에 사람들은 감탄을 합니다.
Already slumped. They're on their way back up. They're just so confident right now.
So as Wildgrowth used just about saving his life, they're actually thinking of going back in for this red buff, and that's not worth a flash.
It hit Yellow. The small red.
Oh, wow. Oh, Yellowstar, they're trying everything now. They want to get themselves a kill on Faker, but it's not to be. Intervention goes down, but Faker's just going to run a muck through this team, and in comes Lats Rats once again. It's another double kill for Piglet.
That just kind of adds insult to injury right there.
이 장면에서 페이커는 적은 피로 생존해내며 감탄하게 만들었고
Pixel is starting off. Stranglethorns bounces back in the air. Intervention already used, remember. That saved Cyanide's life. Cyanide himself trying to get him towards Boomandu. Does pounce across but can't even get the kill on the support. Faker, meanwhile, sidestepping once again gets out. Cyanide hasn't got the lifesteal. Yellowstar did manage to take down Impact in that fray. And SK Telecom backing out with next to no help. But you've got to feel it is only a matter of time.
Yeah.
여기서 유럽 올스타들을 상대로 1-4 플레이를 해 이 장면은 아직까지 회자되고 있습니다.
We also heard about Faker's found himself another bunch of kills. There's
That's a party though.
Ultimate, look at that. Peke is in all sorts of trouble. Intervention was used. They finally get Faker down, but it took three of them. Telecom, full control of this one.
The Yasuo mechanics right here by Faker, dodging the first binding, going right past the black shield, and then just flying in past the guy with intervention. To try and do as much as possible to Peke because the ultimate actually does damage on the way down.
결국 2014년 올스타 준결승 첫 경기에서 SKT는 Fnatic을 상대로 승리합니다. 그리고 이 경기는 아직까지도 페이커의 야쏘 1-4 명장면으로 회자되고 있습니다.
You promise you won't screw me over. Leave me in the cold. Yeah, I need honest for my confidence. You
promise you won't screw me over. Tell me your. 영상을 시청해 주셔서 정말 감사합니다.